All right, welcome back inside our proactive newsroom. And joining me now is Ian Atkinson. He's the CEO of Southern Energy. And Ian, it's good to see you. How are you?
I'm good today. Thanks, Steve. How are you?
I'm doing very, very well. And you have some really interesting news out today that you've announced the commencement of your drilling program at three of your wells in the Gwinville Gas field. So just tell me a little bit about these wells and why you're targeting these three specific.
Yeah, it's pretty exciting for us, you know, on what we plan to be long-term and significant growth for our shareholders. All three of these wells at Gwinville will be drilled horizontally in what we call the Selma Chalk Reservoir. And it's a significant moment for our company because we haven't been spending a lot of organic growth capital in the last few years. And in Gwinville, specifically in the Selma Chalk, historically, there has been successful horizontal drilling with great results in the past from previous companies. We're really just picking up where they left off, but we're drilling wells that are going to be over 50% longer, over 75% more stages, and more than 50% more stand per stage. So really bringing that modern technology today. And the results of this program are going to be very transformational for us. We expect this to more than double our corporate cash flow and production. Also, it proves up future locations and then even more growth as we follow up with the more continuous program.
Ian, can you talk a little bit more about the horizontal rather than vertical, just so we understand that?
Yeah, horizontal drilling is a more efficient way to redevelop these types of reservoirs because each horizontal well will bring on a much higher daily gas rate and produce more ultimate gas reserves. The other exciting aspect of horizontal drilling is the way we can replicate this application over the rest of our field and prove up more, you know, quick additions to cash flow and reserves as we provide this long-term growth for shareholders.
Yeah. And assuming there is success there, which you're hoping there is, I'm sure, what does these wells mean for the company and the surrounding acreage as well?
Great question. Thanks. So the way we're executing this program is we should see immediate impacts on the company. As I mentioned previously, I think the results should more than double our cash flow and production. We should really look at this program as a growth catalyst, period. This is going to be a very busy time for us. It's that game-changing point where we initiate that significant and long-term growth for shareholders, but also start to add value to the acreage around Gwinville.
Okay. You mentioned a bit of the timeline. Can you go through that again for us? And why are you starting specifically right now in January?
You know, it's an opportune time. We've seen the robust recovery of natural gas prices, so we'd like to take advantage of that point in time. We have great access to services. So when you put that together, this should be very profitable results for us and quick payouts for the company. As far as results, we're drilling all three of these horizontal wells from the same pad to minimize surface disturbance. And we do what's called batch drilling. And simply what that means is all three wells are completely drilled before you get any production results from the first well. And so we plan to complete these three wells in a way that we can learn and optimize a little bit along the way. And initial results we expect to be in April. So quite soon.
All right. Well, we'll look forward to that. Obviously, this is just one part of what the company's doing. Give me some feedback for 2022 and what shareholders can expect.
Sure. It's exciting and transformational, as I mentioned. Plus, we have that macro environment that's very positive for gas. So, you know, upon the completion of the successful three-well program, we look to start which will be continuous growth drilling for Southern in 2022. We have a second zone in Gwinville called the City Bank, which previous companies were also drilling, so we would initiate drilling on that. We also pursue consolidations. In one of my previous discussions here on Proactive, we talked about a focus area we have of geology, so we still are looking at consolidations that would make sense for the company and for shareholders. But personally, you know, what I really look forward to in 2022, and hopefully when some of these restrictions quieten down a bit in Canada and the UK, I look to re-engaging with shareholders face-to-face. I feel like we're a little bit old-fashioned here. We certainly embrace technology to create value, but I like that face-to-face engagement with shareholders and look to travel and obviously shake some hands, but I like to talk to our shareholders face-to-face.
Yeah, be nice to shake hands, not just tap elbows, as they say. So yeah, there you go. We're all wishing for that. Yeah, exactly. We're all wishing for that, Ian, for sure. Hey, great update. Thanks so much. Great to catch up with you, and we'll talk again soon.
That's great. Thanks for the time, and you both have a great day.
Yeah, you as well. There's Ian Atkinson. He is the CEO of Southern Energy.